Welcome to Billy's Place. I'm Billy Hinsche. I'm so glad that you're here. We are going to have such a big time tonight. I'm telling you, this show just got bigger and bigger the more I put it together. So stick around for some great songs, great stories, and I promise you this is going to be a fantastic show. This is show number 65. Unbelievable. I'm calling it the Going Solo Show. And we're going to feature the music of Don Henley, Stevie Nicks, and Carl Wilson, all in their solo efforts. And I'm telling you, there's a lot to get to tonight. So I'm going to just start talking here. Welcome to all the new people that have never been here before. I always love to see your names and faces when I check the comments at the end of the show with my friend Desi Arnaz Jr., who should be showing up here any minute. And I want to welcome the people that have been here all along, that have helped me, supported me out throughout the year. And without you, there's really not much of a show. So anyway, welcome everybody. Let's hit the share button as soon as we can, get the show out to the world. I'm gonna do some my usual comments, such as, do visit my website, billyhinsche.com, for all manner of things of interest. Do visit my YouTube channel, Billy Hinsche Official, which has all sorts of things to look at there too. I'm moving a little bit quickly because there's just a lot going on tonight. Not only is that, oh, by the way, all the videos that you'll find on the YouTube channel, they are free for your viewing. Enjoy them, they're free, brothers and sisters, as is this show. And I would encourage you, if you like what I've been doing all this time, there's a PayPal link, there's a Venmo link, send in a little something in support of the show, would you? And that would help me, and I always give a portion of the proceeds to MusiCares, which helps musicians. Now, I have a very special idea tonight. I'm calling this my birthday special giveaway show. I've got a birthday coming up in a couple of days, and what I want to do is this. If you send in something in support of the show, I want to give something back to you. So if you send something in via PayPal or Venmo, and you specify what it is you might like, I want to send something back to you. Whether it's a Beach Boy pass, a Jan and Dean button, Chicago memorabilia laminate, Dino, Desi, and Billy signed autograph, 8x10, signed by me and Desi. You get the idea. So send in something, call it I'm calling it the birthday blowout giveaway. I want to give back to you. If you give to me, I will give back to you, and I will happily do that. So that's my big idea for tonight. I'll mention it again throughout the course of the show. I think it was a good idea. I'll send you something really interesting, rock and roll memorabilia. Thank you, guest callers from the number 64 show, the Chicago style show. I want to thank Ron Alexenberg, our record exec, who knows everybody and gave us a tour of Chicago and with his comments and suggestions. Jason Schiff, longtime lead singer and bass player for the group Chicago. We want to thank him. He's got his own group now with one of the cats from Rascal Flatts. And boy, considered number one drummer in the world by some, Todd Zuckerman. We thank him so much. He played with Brian Wilson. He's playing with Styx currently. I forgot to mention last week, during my Todd Zuckerman phone call, I forgot to mention that the show he worked on for me, for Carl Wilson Foundation, it was headlined by Brian Wilson. Small detail. Yeah, the show was Robert Lamb, Timothy B. Schmidt, David Marks, Ricky Martin, Dewey Bunnell, probably Carney and Wendy were at that show at the El Rey. Anyway, wanted to mention that Brian was our headliner. You know, oh boy, that Chicago show was great. You know, remember that last week? Boy, oh boy. We did a lot of great songs, covered a lot of material. I used to live in Chicago. I don't think you know that. Yeah. But then I moved to the suburbs that I've really felt out of the loop. Uh-oh, he's starting. He's starting. I want to thank my graphics artist this week, Valerie Samatis. She did a terrific job of making a poster of an old photo of me on stage with Dino Desi, playing my Rickenbacker with the audience in the background. She did a great job. Thank you, Valerie. I want to congratulate the trivia contest winner, Mr. Michael Brown. He was the first to correctly name James William Guercio as being the bass player for the Beach Boys during the 1975 Beachago tour, Beach Boys Chicago tour, and that Caribou was the name of his company. I'll bet a lot of you knew the answer to that. Yeah, well, here we are in Vegas. I'm gonna sing you a little song. Getting hot here in Vegas. I bought a loaf of bread and I brought it home. By the time I got it home, it was toast. So you know what I did? I threw a couple of eggs in the swimming pool and poached them and put them on the toast, and there was breakfast. You know, even the Tabasco sauce tastes mild in this heat here in Vegas. I am here to tell you, it is heating up. All right, let's go. Let's do this thing. Hello, my friend. It's good to see you again. I guess it's been a few years since I've been away, but I'm happy to say I'm doing okay myself. I can dig what's happening, and every day there is something new, and hey, good things are coming my way. Tell me how you've been. There's so much you gotta tell me. Let's talk about them good old days when we laugh and say, hey, hey, life okay. Don't go away so soon now. Well, it's a brand new year. Lots of things are happening, and hey, good things are coming my way. Tell me, how you been? There's so much you gotta tell me. Let's talk about them good old days when we laugh and say, hey, hey, man, you're okay. Don't go away so soon now. Let's get on back to that groove. Stay around. Okay, very good. We're off to a good start, I think. I don't think David Bowie would mind that I borrowed that little snippet from his Space Oddity song. He wouldn't mind. I went to a party with him once, yeah. It was at a birthday party for my pal Ricky Martin. It was his 21st birthday back there in 1974. Yeah, a couple other folks were there of interest. Oh, I don't know, Elizabeth Taylor, Henry Mancini, Brian Wilson, Elton John, May Pang, and a couple of Beatles, John and Ringo, but you know. Just another day at the office. Yes, indeedy. Speaking of birthdays, yeah, my birthday's in a couple of days. Yeah, I bought myself a new vest. You like this? This is from the Liberace garage sale. Like it? Yep. Well, it's a big week for me. Big week. I was wondering I had a question. What do baseball games and birthday cakes have in common? Baseball games and birthday cakes. They both need a good batter. They need. Mm-hmm. You know, last year I asked my baker why my birthday cake was so hard. He told me it was marble cake. Got to call in the referee on that one. I think he called a foul on that one. Okay, I am going to move into the Don Henley segment. Boy, oh boy, Don Henley, as a solo artist, did such great things. You know, I had a chance to spend a little time with him over the years. The Eagles opened for the Beach Boys a number of times. We weren't too friendly, but I got to know Glenn Frey a little bit, rest his soul. And I spent time with Don in Detroit at the Northfield Hilton, if you know where that is. It was during his solo tour. I think it was maybe Building the Perfect Beast, his album, in support of his album, and Carl Wilson's solo tour. They sort of cross paths as artists do in rock and roll, you know, one group's leaving and the other's coming in, sort of a thing. And I spent a little time backstage at an Eagles show here in Vegas at the MGM Grand. I was a guest of Timothy B. Schmidt, and I brought my buddy John Stamos with me, and we hung out and, you know, did a little small talk, chit chat. So yeah, this next song is from Don's solo album, Building the Perfect Beast. It was his second solo effort, 1984. It went 3 times platinum. Now, that is really saying something. Going gold is one thing, going platinum, but 3 times platinum, de salud. Yeah, he collaborated with Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers members on writing many of his songs, and many of his guest artists included Randy Newman, our friend Miss Go-Go Belinda Carlisle, drummer Jim Keltner, Toto's keyboardist Steve Porcaro, guitarist Waddy Wachtel, who works with Stevie Nicks and Linda Ronstadt, Warren Zevon, and not to mention Keith Richards. Anyway, Don works with the best. Forget the rest. Okay, I'm going to dial in the sound that I need, and we're going to get on with it. As I said, this is a really big show. We are certainly going to go longer than an hour tonight. I can guarantee that. So I hope that pleases you, my good squires and squirelesses. Okay, I think we've got something here. Okay, almost ready to go. This is such a great song. Oh, check that beat. Yeah. We don't like that voice. Oh boy, my piano's already messing with me. Here we go.
Home, but I can see you, a brown skin shine.
out your hair, comb back, get your sunglasses on, baby. I can tell you my love for you will still be strong after the boys of summer have gone. I never will forget those nights. I wonder if it was a dream. Remember you made me crazy. Remember how I made you scream. Now I don't want to understand what happened to our love. Well, babe, I'm gonna get you back. Gonna show you what I'm made of. And I can see you. Brown skin shining in the sun. I see you working real slow and I'm smiling. First heard that song, but it's also associated with baseball, baseball players. So whatever, choose your interpretation. That song won a Grammy and 4 MTV Music Video Awards. Wow, incredible, fantastic. Yep, Don wrote some great stuff. I have a question. Do you know what would Pancho Villa? Yeah. Do you know what would Pancho Villa would be known as if he rode a motor scooter instead of a horse? What would Pancho Villa be known as if he rode a motor scooter and not a horse? He'd be a Vesperado. Vesperado. Brrr. Now if he drove a Cadillac, he'd be an Eldorado. Seal of approval. Yeah, don't be changing Don's lyrics. Uh-oh, he doesn't like that. Don't be changing the lyric to peaceful, cheesy feeling for your enchilada commercial anytime soon. Wouldn't be a good idea. Okay, I got something real special lined up. Don't go away. I've got to get out my secret weapon. And, yeah, we're going to do another Don Henley solo song, which I know you know and love. I'll be right back in two shakes. Talk amongst yourselves. Now, that didn't take long, did it? Almost back. Now I'm back. See what I'm talking about here? Got the old Rickenbacker out for this next song, ladies and gentlemen. didn't wanna hear, but I knew that it would come. An old true friend of ours was knocking on the phone. She said, you found someone. Happiness, they're the very things we kill, I guess. Oh, pride and competition cannot fill these empty arms. And a work I'll put between us, you know it doesn't keep me warm. Get box, I'll be right back.
Talk amongst yourselves. Oh
look, there wasn't even enough time to talk amongst yourselves. I'm back. Okay, well, I need a little sip here after that one. Yeah, you know, Don was an English major, and he and Glenn Fry didn't really know how to write songs properly until they started hanging around Jackson Brown. They all live in the same apartment complex, and yeah, they learned the ropes from Jackson. Did I tell you I was evicted from a karaoke bar last night? Evicted, ejected. Yeah, I got evicted and ejected from a karaoke bar last night for singing Footloose 5 times in a row. Yeah, apparently I exceeded the maximum number of logins. Boy, no one wants to cooperate with me after that one. Okay, be that way. Be that way. Well, this next tune is one of my favorites. It was all over MTV, and I'm sure you probably have seen it. You know, regarding that singing all those karaoke songs in a row, I failed at math in high school. Did I tell you that? I failed at math in high school so many times I can't count. Now we're talking. Why am I talking like Johnny Cash all of a sudden? It's a little dry, Gulch. Well, I'm here to tell you, we have got a lot more show. I'm gonna just start this song and see where it goes, okay? That's what I'm gonna do. Okay, let me get set up. There's a couple little things, you know, that I got to do. You just never know. Okay, wow, I can't believe that it cooperated with me. Check that tempo. Well, they're digging out the prisoners, put them in a pen. Them up right in the kitchen sink. All she wants to do it. But there's crazy people rocking around with the blood in their eyes. All she wants to do is dance. But wild eyed pistol waves ain't afraid to die. All she wants to do it. Negro man, can't you feel the heat? Coming off the street, she wants to party, she wants to get down. All she wants to do is, all she wants to do is. Now looky here, well, the government bugged the men's room in the local distill lounge. All she wants to do is. Keep them boys from selling all the weapons they can scrounge. All she wants to do is dance. But that don't keep the boys from making it a buck or two. All she wants to do is dance. They can still sell all the army, all the drugs that they can do, yeah. All she wants to do is, all she wants to do is. Oh, we have got to stop right there. I got a very special caller. Hello. You got him. Hey, man. So great to hear from you. What a day I've had since I last talked to you. It got so much better. So much better. Oh, yeah. It couldn't get any worse. Listen, would you mind if I put you on speaker and introduce you to my viewers? All right. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm so thrilled and happy and honored to have this gentleman on the phone with us this evening. He is, we go way back, a lot of years. But he's like the number one guitar player, number one call anywhere that you see some important rock and roll event, whether it's you know, the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame or the Kennedy Center Awards. This cat is going to be on stage. He's backed up Linda Ronstadt, Stevie Nicks. Hell, he's worked with Keith Richards. Everybody, this is Waddy Wachtel. Waddy, would you say hello to my viewers, please?
Hello, everybody. Hey, Billy. How are you, my friend? Hello, everyone. Nice to be here.
Well, I'm telling you, I got to tell them briefly. When I spoke with Waddy earlier, my car had just died. I needed a new battery. And I'm in Vegas, and it's 110. Long story short, I got a battery, and you know, it can only go up from that moment. So I'm on a real high. And Waddy, so great to have you here. Your list of credits is incredible. And I mean, I want to tell the folks, you know, Carl and I don't know how we met, a mutual friend, but you had a group long time ago called Twice Nicely, yes?
Yes, that's right. Yeah, we met through Artie, actually, Artie Geller.
Okay. Very good. Very good.
Steve Korthoff and the family and the Wilsons.
Oh, wow. Well, now it's all coming back to me. Well, and we're talking late 60s, early 70s?
Yeah, very late. Yeah, I moved to L.A. in 68, so, and I met Arnie within the first couple of months. So, yeah, we're talking late 68, 69, yeah.
Well, yeah, when your guys' group was so great, and Carl and I, you know, we were shopping some demos, and, you know, we went to a couple of places, but, you know, it just wasn't happening, but we sure thought you guys were great. I even remember one of the song titles, Killed in Velvet, am I right?
Oh, wow, really? Amazing. I just actually recently got the demo of that song back. Hadn't heard it since we're talking about that period, but Judy Culver, who was the girl in our band, she went back home to Rhode Island, and the demo, our old demo, was there, so she brought it back and sent me a digital copy of it. It's, that's wild. You remember that song, Billy? I'm so knocked out.
Dude, I'm telling you, well, it was a great song, and also I've got one of those memories, you know, it's kind of a blessing and a curse. I remember, like, maybe too much stuff, you know, but that was one of the good memories. So,
right.
You know, Waddy, when I was originally hoping that you'd call, it was in regard to Stevie Nicks, and, you know, could you share some stories about Stevie? But then when I realized it, you have been touched, or you have touched the careers and the lives of everyone on my show, from Don Henley to Stevie to Carl Wilson in some way. Oh, I have to ask you real quick, did you play on Warren Zevon's Desperados Under the Eaves?
Yes.
Okay, well, there's the connection with me and Carl for that song, because Carl and I and Jackson sang.
Oh, right, yeah, that's right. But we had met before that, Bill.
Oh, yes.
Before that.
Oh, yes, absolutely.
Definitely, yeah. I remember when you guys came and sang on that.
Yeah, and every time I see Jackson, I thank him. It's like one of my best credits, you know, obviously. And and I was just rattling off some of the folks that Henley has worked with. Of course, you're on the list for that. Did you work on, was it Boys of Summer or All She Wants to Do Is Dance? Or Building the Perfect Beast is basically what it was, right?
Well, I actually worked on Three of Don's albums, his first solo album. I was on that quite a bit, the second one, and then Beast. I'm one of the voices going building, but I also played on a very cool song on that album as well. There's some great stuff. My partner, Danny Korchmar, wrote and produced a lot of that music that Don succeeded with. All She Wants to Do Is Dance and Dirty Laundry are basically Danny Korchmar's songs. Well, especially Dance. Laundry, Don wrote the incredible lyrics to that, but
yeah.
What's to do with Dance is Danny's tune completely. And Danny, and we have a band now, Danny Korchmar, myself, Russ Kunkel, and Leland Sklar, and a new guy that nobody has heard of yet named Steve Postel, who's also beautifully talented. And we got a band called The Immediate Family. After 50 years of playing together, we finally realized, wait a minute, we should play together.
Well, I know, and I'm aware of the group. In fact, if you recall, at the Rock and Roll Fantasy Camp, I was counselor, and there was a Paul Stanley was there, and you guys did like, we'll call it a master class. You did a show at the Rock and Roll Fantasy Camp here in Vegas.
That was the first birth of the band, really. It took us a while to realize this is what we should be doing all the time. But we came en masse to go to that thing and to give that class. Yeah, that's right.
And I mean, I've seen YouTubes of the immediate family, and of course, you guys are incredible. Any gigs planned now that things are opening up?
Well, yeah, we have a tour booked for November on the East Coast, a bunch of dates. Got a couple of things in California too, early November, and they'll be all over the websites real soon and all over Facebook. But yeah, we wanted to wait till November to try to make sure everything is safe enough to go out there.
Sure, of course, that's totally reasonable.
Pretty frightened about putting a crowd together in front of us, so.
Yeah.
A little scary. Stevie has gigs in September to make up, like so many other people. We lost so many gigs, almost 2 years ago. So we have big gigs in September to make up. And we're very scared about September. Seems a little early. So I hope everybody's vaccinated, masking up, and staying careful, because it's too frightening to have to go through what we went through.
I agree, and more power to you. I talked to Bobby Herr earlier today. Does that name ring a bell?
Of course. Yeah. Bobby Herr is one of my guys.
Yeah? Well, he was a Beach Boy guy for a lot of years, and we chat.
Oh, yeah, that's right. He told me that. I'm sure he was. Yeah.
Yep. And we...
Bobby is wonderful.
I know. We swapped some stories earlier. I'm going to play a little pre-recorded thing that we did with him a little bit later on in the show. I was wondering if you had a sweet tale about Stevie Nicks, a story, something funny, something touching, anything you could share with our viewers?
Well, I mean, there's so many moments.
I'm sure.
She's one of those gifts to us all, you know, like there are certain entertainers like Dolly Parton or like Stevie Nicks that don't come along too often. And she's got an incredible sense of humor. She's beautiful to work with. We've been playing together since her first solo album. I mean, I played with her on their Buckingham Nicks record before the Fleetwood Mac album.
Mm-hmm.
So that's when we all met through Keith Olsen. If you knew Keith, I'm not sure if you knew Keith Olsen.
The name is so familiar.
He was a tremendous producer, record producer. He passed away recently, but he introduced me to Stevie and Lindsey, and we did their Buckingham Nicks record. And then Stevie called me to do her solo album, her first solo album, Belladonna, and Edge 17, and everything. And we've been on the road together and in the studio together since then, basically. She said one funny thing was when the people were putting together one of the tours, and talking about the travel, you know, Stevie, she's been on the road for so many years with the Mac that she got very used to traveling a certain way. And as they were putting together the travel for this tour, she just went, well, Waddy and I are too old for the bus. we're not going on the bus. And so I get to fly with her when we go from town to town. And we keep it pretty humorous up there. But it's crazy because I'll get to a town earlier, you know, some hours earlier than my band will.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm there with Evie and her makeup girl and her assistant and as one guy with a bunch of women. And, you know, we get to the hotel and I'm like, so I go to my room and I'm like alone. And it's like, you know, it's like this life of luxury. However, it's more like, what am I doing? You know, I'm alone here, you know, and then and coming to town for about four more, five more hours.
Yeah, right.
To get here, I'm going to be asleep. So it's a comedy of errors out there on the road.
Oh, believe me. Yeah, believe me, I know about that. Now, that is so great. I'm wondering, you've worked with everybody, all the really big names, and including Keith Richards. Do you have a little anecdote about Keith you could share with us?
Well, it's hard to really nail down these moments, Billy, you know.
I mean, yeah.
Keith is, quite a bunch of guys, let's put it that way.
Okay.
And he is, you know, people talk to me about Keith. And what is he like? You know, oh, I'll tell you what's funny. When we did Saturday Night Live, by the way, when we did that show, that was the first time the band, the Expensive Winos, we were called.
I know, yep.
That was the first gig we ever did on national TV with Keith playing for millions of people. We hadn't even done a club gig.
Yes.
So that was our debut. And we were pretty relaxed. And it, when you see it, it looked like we've been together forever, doing it forever. But the band was so amazing.
Yeah.
Everybody in that band was so incredibly gifted and talented. So it was every show we did was an unbelievable pleasure and thrilling. But the funny thing was, that night of the show, we came walking off the rehearsal, and John Lovett, who was one of the cast members,
I know John.
And I lied. You know, Keith walks by him, and I'm like a little behind, you know, I'm straggling behind. So I'm watching John observe Keith, and Keith walks by him, and he's looking at him, and then I come walking up, and he looks at me, and he goes, "That's Keith Richards." I went, yeah, I know. He goes, he's not tall. I thought he was really tall. He's not all that tall. I said, "Well, you're not very tall either." And John goes, "Oh, yeah, you're right."
That's hysterical. Is there anybody that you haven't worked with, Waddy, that you'd like to work with?
Well, there are a lot of people I've yet to work with, and I hope I get the chance to. I've met Ringo. I never got to meet George Harrison. I did meet John Lennon once, and I'm really looking forward to the moment where I could meet Paul McCartney and shake his hand.
Mm-hmm. Well, those are some good choices, you know. I've never had the pleasure of meeting George. I would have loved to, but c'est la vie, you know.
Yeah.
Well, man, I want to thank you so much for calling in, Waddy. I really appreciate your time, and you know, it's just great to hear your voice again. And I really hope that when you swing through Vegas, you'll look me up and we can get together and have some laughs.
Absolutely, man. It's wonderful to catch up with you. I miss you, buddy. It's nice to hear you, too.
I miss you, too, man. Let's all hear it for Waddy Wachtel, everybody. Big round of applause. Waddy, God bless you. Thank you so much, and we'll talk again soon.
All right, Billy. Be good. Bye. Goodbye, everybody. Take good care of yourself. Thanks, Bill.
Thank you, sir. Come on now. Waddy Wachtel, guitarist extraordinaire. You know him, you love him. If you don't know who I'm talking about, he's very recognizable. He's very slender. He has a big head of hair, glasses. He's always got the beautiful Les Paul or some fantastic acoustic 12-string guitar. I saw him backing up Stevie Nicks and Harry Styles, who inducted her into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. But anyway, thank you, Waddy Wachtel. What a great call to get. Wow. You know, I think we've heard enough of All She Wants to Do is Dance, right? We get a big chunk of that. I'm going to move into the Stevie Nicks segment, which happens to include Don Henley, because they do a duet called Leather and Lace. For those of you who do not know, Stevie was a longtime member of the group Fleetwood Mac. And she went solo in 1981. Her debut album, Belladonna, went number one on Billboard, the album charts. And it was also her best-selling album in the U.S. Now, six of her eight studio albums reached the U.S. top 10. And in 2019, she was the first female artist inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame for the second time. That is quite an honor. Yeah, she was inducted for Fleetwood and then as a solo artist. And as I mentioned, Harry Styles inducted her. So I'm going to move back over here so I can face you nice people and face the music, literally. And if you know the song, sing along. You know, I'm singing both parts, just like I did with the duet show. Yes, indeed. All right. Gonna move back. Go. Oh no, I got another. I got another guitar song. But you know what I want to do? I want to play an interview that I did with Stevie's road manager. I mentioned him to Waddy. And Waddy, of course, remembered him immediately. But he's now, you know, he worked for the Beach Boys, and now he works for Stevie. And he has worked with a bunch of people. And I want to play this interview I did with him earlier because of his schedule. He was getting on a plane. His name is Bobby Herr, and we love Bobby. And here goes the interview. Enjoy. All right, everybody. I'm on the air with my dear friend for many, many years. He worked with the Beach Boys for about 5.5 years, starting in 1986. He has traveled the world with me. We have logged thousands and thousands of miles together and a lot of great experiences. He's chuckling because he's thinking about some of those miles and experiences.
So many.
Anyway, his name is Bobby Herr, and he's worked with so many people. We'll get into that in a minute. But Bobby, would you say hello to my viewers, please?
Hello, viewers of Mr. Bill Co., Billy Hinsche, the magical, the marvelous.
Wow. Well, yeah, I'm sometimes called Bill Co. We used to call Bobby Chief. Chief, what's going on, Chief? Because he was the chief. What was your role with the Beach Boys? Did you change positions over the years?
When I started, Chaz brought me in, who was the production manager.
Chaz Yost, yes.
Yeah, Chaz Yost. And I was, came in as Carl's guitar tech.
Uh-huh, right.
Carl Wilson's guitar tech. Mm-hmm. Started there, so I was over there stage left. And then I was the stage manager, and I did Carl's guitars. And then you remember when we had like a B system, and we were like sometimes doing two shows a day? Remember that nonsense?
Absolutely, A system, B system, you bet.
Yeah, so I was the production manager for one of the systems, and then Matt, who was the tour manager.
Matt Shepard.
Brought me in as the road manager.
Fantastic.
Well, with Elliot Lott's blessing, of course.
Elliot Lott being what would we describe?
Manager,
of course. And because Elliot worked his way up the ranks too. You know, he worked for Carl on a personal level as Carl's limo driver, Carl and my sister. Did you know that? Yeah.
Yeah.
So yeah. Well, everybody, you know, if they're there long enough, just works their way up the ranks. With the Beach Boys, or I guess any other organization. Anyway, I'm so happy to have you here, Bobby. It's great to hear your voice.
Happy to be here.
Well, I was thinking that, you know, I'm doing this show tonight called Going Solo, and you have experiences with everybody on the show: Don Henley, Stevie Nicks, and Carl Wilson. Can we start with Stevie Nicks? Because you're currently working with Stevie. You've worked with her for how long?
Since 2003.
Because you were with Fleetwood Mac before she went solo, correct?
I was actually, I was with Fleetwood Mac first, and that's how I met Stevie.
Right.
And then she started doing her own stuff. She's been doing her own stuff for years and years, like through the 80s and stuff like that. But yes, I came in and started working on her solo projects as well as the production manager.
And I gotta say, prior to all of that, you were working with our friend Paula Abdul, right?
Yes, oh yeah.
I'm telling you, Bobby, you have really covered the waterfront here. Tell us a little bit about Stevie Nicks working for her, her modus operandi. You know, is she an easy boss? Is she a taskmaster? What is she?
I love her to death, and she is a joy to work with.
Well, that's good to hear. That's great.
Yeah, she's a lovely person. She's super gracious. She's loyal to, I've told her to her face, she's loyal to a fault.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes not in her best interest, but mm-hmm. she's such a good, giving person. And she likes things done a certain way, like rock stars do, especially when they're getting into their 70s. And everybody knows what that is and how things should be done, and you don't deviate from it, and it's smooth sailing, and it's like, I tell you, it's just a joy to go out on those tours, because it's just like, it's like family. And everybody knows everybody, and everybody's been around for a while, and when new people come in, you know, they just are like, oh my God, I can't believe how amazing this is. You know, like a lot of those camps, you know, like Jimmy Buffett and some of those Chicago and some of those older bands that have been around for a long time where it's the same folks. But yeah, it's great. I love it. And same with Fleetwood Mac, too. It's one big, huge family.
Well, and yes, and the people that you've worked with included, you know, Lionel Richie, Sheryl Crow. I mean, you were really in the top echelon of these people. And there's a reason for, because you're good. You're a pro, right?
I think that I think I've always have said this when I've spoke to, you know, colleges and music programs and people, interviews, is that, you know, if you're good at your job and if you have some integrity and you do a great job, you will always work in this business. And this business isn't as big as everybody thinks it is.
How do you
mean? Everybody knows everybody for the most part, you know, from a tour management, production management aspect.
I see what you mean.
There's some, I'm not saying I'm one of the top dogs, but there's a, you know, there's like, I can name like 10 people, you know, at each position, and those people are always working. And luckily, knock on wood, I am one of those.
Yes, you are. You said the word integrity, and that always brings up the notion of Carl Wilson to me. Tell the folks a little bit about your relationship with Carl, what he meant to you personally and professionally.
Yeah. So Carl, you know, I started off as his guitar tech. We got along famously, and I love that man. He was, trying not to get choked up here, Billy.
I understand.
I loved working with him. He was such a kind, quiet spirit, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And such an amazing singer and musician and taskmaster too. I mean, I think that for the viewers, I think Billy would agree that when Carl was there, he was running the ship musically.
Oh, hell yeah.
So, yeah. So it was always, he was always there to do that. And shit got done. Mm-hmm. And it was just, I loved him. I loved Gina, his wife. It was fun to, you know, spend time with their families and the boys, Carl's boys, and mom when she was around.
Yeah, dear Audrey.
Audrey, what a precious person she was.
Yeah.
But I love Carl and I miss him dearly.
Oh, so do we.
And I miss his music.
Yeah. Well,
imagine what he would have done.
Oh my gosh. Well, you see it all the time. People doing their versions of God Only Knows, which, you know, everybody knows Brian wrote that for his wife Marilyn, but not everybody knows that Carl sang that with his wife in mind, my sister Annie.
Yeah, right.
So, anyway, a quick story about Don Henley to shift gears here. We've talked about everybody on the show except for Don. I know you got to be a little careful with Don Henley stories, but you got a safe one you can tell us?
Well, I mean, here's the thing about Don. Don, he could be he's a real taskmaster, and, you know, he really, really is good at his craft, and he likes things a certain way. Things have to be played exactly the way he wants them to be played.
Uh-huh.
I mean, it's harder on the musicians than anything, and he's got the same guys now, but it's just like, he is really like note for note, what was on the record, don't deviate, you know, and he's got an ear like you would not believe.
Mm-hmm.
He's amazing that way, musically. He's a tough cookie, man. You gotta really watch yourself, and I know there's a lot of, like, most volatile positions on the crew, like being his tech or the monitor guy, you know, that's always drama. But Don, I think, so we did just 2 years ago. Actually, it's probably, I'm losing track of time with COVID now. So
mm-hmm.
Probably maybe 2.5-3 years ago, Stevie was inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame as the first female solo artist.
By Harry Styles.
By Harry Styles. And so, who was a great kid. And Don came up, we rehearsed with Don, and they did Leather and Lace together.
Mm-hmm.
So Stevie's out there starting it, Waddy Wachtel's out there, get the band going, and they break into Leather and Lace, and of course, the first couple of verses are Stevie's, and then Don came out. So Mike, I spent about 4 days with Don on that, and this is obviously after Glenn passed,
mm-hmm.
and from the Eagles.
Yeah.
And I just see a more kinder, softer Don Henley now.
Oh, well, that's good to know. Great.
Yeah. I mean, I haven't toured with him in years, but it just felt, he felt more peaceful, like he was, I don't know, we're all getting older and we're starting to lose people, and
yeah.
And you think about your own mortality, I guess. And
sure.
When you're surrounded by that kind of stuff. So that's what I kind of saw from Don. Like I said, and I love it. I love his music. I love his solo stuff. Always have.
Yeah, he's incredible. I'm going to do Leather and Lace on the show tonight.
Awesome.
Now, on a closing note, what are you doing now? What are your plans? What's in the future for you, Mr. Bobby Herr?
So, like I told you before, I just got back from New Zealand with Crowded House, so I've been working with Neil Finn a lot.
Mm-hmm. Who's with Fleetwood Mac now.
Yep, he's with Fleetwood now. And that's how we met. So I was in New Zealand because it was COVID-free, and we were there for 9 weeks. And we were actually the first band to tour in the world.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
Since COVID hit.
That is
so that was kind of our mark. So it was really surreal to leave California in the middle of COVID, go to New Zealand, and be locked up in a hotel for 2 weeks and, you know, in quarantine. And then we had a week of rehearsals, and then we started our tour. But, like, just to walk out into a festival, you know, where we're headlining, and there's 14 to 15,000 people there. It was just, like, crazy.
Did you get did you get as far south as a place called Hokitika? We played the Wild Food Festival. Me, Robert Lamb, Jeff Fosquet. Did you get that far? Andy
Kim? Oh, my God, no. Well, the farthest south we would get would be Dunedin.
Okay.
That's the furthest south.
Okay.
That sounds like it's probably way down there.
It is so far down. Next stop is Antarctica.
Yeah.
I'm serious.
It's crazy. So what I'm doing now is that I'm with getting ready to start Stevie.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to start rehearsals at the beginning of August. She'll rehearse for about 3 weeks. And then we have a few dates that are coming up.
Mm-hmm.
And it's all stuff that was postponed from 2020.
I'll bet.
So
yeah, sure.
So all those dates were still sitting on the book, so we're going to go do that. And then in October and November, I will be going to Australia with Crowded House.
Fantastic. Well, I hope if you come through Las Vegas, you give me a shout. I'd love to see you again, Mr. Bobby Herr.
Absolutely. It was so great to be on your show. Thanks for inviting me.
You got it, man. Safe travels. Love you lots. God bless you and your family. And I'll see you soon, man.
All right, buddy.
Thanks,
Take
buddy.
Care.
Bye-bye.
Yeah. Love you, bud.
Love you, too.
Wasn't that a great interview with Mr. Bobby Herr? I'm here to tell you, he is one of the good guys. You know, there's a lot of people in the business, rock and roll, and a lot of really good people. But I'm telling you, Bobby is really special. He is his sweetheart, and I am very thankful that he called in this fine evening. Boy, oh boy. I'm telling you, folks, there's a lot more show. I'm so glad that you are here. There's just so much more to do. I've got another duet here I'm going to be doing, this time, Stevie and Tom Petty. I tell you, I got to have another drink here and cool off. It is getting so hot here in Vegas. You know, I saw Peter Dinklage standing in a Dixie cup full of lemonade. It was so hot today. I saw him. No, really, I did. My drummer has turned on me again. I should have left Peter Dinklage out of this. But I didn't. Okay, let me just cool myself off here a little bit. Good golly. Woo-wee. Okay, more music. I hope you enjoyed that interview. So nice of Bobby to take time. Oh, I even have a tempo on this one. Boy, what am I doing? I better get set up here. Yeah. Yeah, this is a Stevie Tom Petty song. Stevie really wanted to be in the Heartbreakers after she had finished the album Tusk with Fleetwood Mac, and Tom Petty said, well, you know, there are no girls in the Heartbreakers, but she kept pushing, and she finally got to do that duet with Tom. So, kind of sort of got her way, in a sense. Well, it brings me now to the Carl Wilson segment and the trivia contest. It is a fabulous package. This is really, I think, the best package I've ever put together, because it is this going solo show. This is the Carl segment. It's my birthday show, and so I'm feeling in a good mood, and I want to give things back to all of you. Remember what I said. If you send in a little something via PayPal or Venmo in any amount and specify what it is you'd like me to send you, whether it is a Beach Boy related piece of memorabilia, Jan and Dean, a Mike and Dean, a Chicago, a Dino, Desi, and Billy, photo signed by me and Desi. You let me know, and I'm going to give back to you because you've given so much to me. Thank you so much for being here. Trivia contest time. Look at what I have. Oh my gosh. I have four things. Count them. Four things. And they go like this. Here's the first one. This is, I've given one of these away before. This is a Beckley Lamb Wilson postcard, promotional postcard. Just in mint condition. That's that. Put that over there. Then we have, along the same lines as in memory of Carl, I have this beautiful Carl Wilson Foundation lapel pin. I wear these on my suit lapels on occasion. There's a little pin you put right there. It says Carl Wilson Foundation in the color blue. Now, this song right here was is a downloadable card that you can listen to. It is a song that Carl and Myrna Smith wrote and sang on called This Is Elvis. I've talked about this before in the Walking in Memphis show, so that's a downloadable card for you. And lastly, there's this great pin, this Elvis pin with the same beautiful graphic that my friend Greer Upton did. We got permission from the Elvis Presley Estate and Graceland to allow us to use Elvis's image and sort of make it our own. So those are the four things. Pretty good prize package, right? Now, if you won before, please don't play, because we want others to have a chance to win. But tonight, everyone's a winner. Take part in my fabulous birthday package giveaway. It'll be fun. Here's the question. It's in three parts, because this is such a fabulous package, it's got to be a little bit hard. So, who produced Carl Wilson's second solo album, Youngblood, in 1981? What was his nickname? I need his name and his nickname. And what two very well-known rock groups was he in prior to this as a musician? I'll repeat. One, who produced Carl Wilson's second solo album, Youngblood, in 1981? What was his name? Two, what was his nickname that he's well known for? Three, what two very well-known rock groups was he in prior to this as a musician himself? Okay? So there we have it. Good luck. Go and do and be. I wish you luck. Fabulous package tonight. Okay, I'm getting a style here. We're going to do this next song. We're going to do This Is Elvis. I don't think it's ever been done before. Because who else would do it but me, right? I'm the guy that does all the obscure material. Have you noticed? Yes, I am. And I'm happy to do it. Because I get a kick out of you. Okay. This is a sweet song. It was originally meant for a movie. It was written in the fall of 1980. It was intended for a film called This Is Elvis, a documentary. It never made the cut because they ended up using a real never-before-heard Elvis song, something like that. And our friend Andrew Salt was behind that production, and Malcolm Leo, the filmmaker. Andrew Salt being the gentleman that owns all the Ed Sullivan shows, which is pretty nice.
There's no way I can explain.
pleasures you employ. My one wish is that you be at peace for eternity. I can still feel your presence here. I can feel you watching me on the stage. You played your goal in my life, the starry role. This is Ellen with a voice of love and strength. You gave though your heart was spent. Innovator that you are, you may rock and roll star. You boldly stepped on to the stage at a much too tender age. Overwhelming ear and eye, you left without a last goodbye. This is Ellen. This is Ellen. Indeedy. That was recorded in 1980 at Caribou Ranch in Netherland, Colorado, and it was mixed in 2014 at No Name Studio, Boston, Mass, and released September 29, 2015 by us. And Chris Cameron was the executive producer. He oversaw everything. I had a little bit of a hand in getting it to the public. So whoever wins that trivia contest will have a card. You can download that card, that song from the card. And yeah, would you believe I have one more very brief interview with Carl's guitar player from the Carl Wilson solo tour. His name is John Daly, and he took a little time off from his busy schedule. He's out doing a gig tonight. And I'm going to play this for you because we took the time and we want you to hear his comments about Carl. So this, ladies and gentlemen, is John Daly. Check it out.
All right, I am on the air with my good buddy who has played with Carl Wilson, which is really saying something. He is a kick-ass guitar player and vocalist. Ladies and gentlemen, please say hello to John Daly. And John Daly, would you say hello to my viewers, please?
Hello to the viewers. So happy to be here. This is really great, Billy. Thank you very much.
Well, you're very welcome. You're very deserving because there aren't too many people that I know that get asked by Carl Wilson to play in his band, and you happen to be one of them. It's a very short list. Can you give us? Yes, it is. And can you give us one of your memories of working with Carl, either on the road or in the studio? Because you work with him for a couple of years there, didn't you?
Yes, I did, from October 1980 until, I guess it was close to 82, we did the second album. So, yeah, I did two studios and a whole bunch of tour dates. And my biggest memory is just how sweet a guy he was. You know, that was my real first exposure to legends. Come on. I mean, you know, there's rock stars and then there's legends. And Carl and the boys are legends, as are you. That's why I'm so thrilled by this. He was so humble. He was so sweet and so giving. That's That's what I remember the most.
Yeah, well, you are among the majority of people that say that, and well deserving to Carl. You got a memorable story, a funny story that happened on the road or in the studio involving Carl?
Funny story? Let's see. I remember I had my pedals stolen. We used to bring down the lights at the end of the last song, and they were down for 2 or 3 seconds. And when they came back up again, the pedals on my pedal board were just gone. Carl says, "Oh my goodness, who ran away with them?" I said, "I don't know, but they're gone." I had to go out by a couple more the next day.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. Well, who steals the pedals off a board? I mean, it's no power supplies or
a desperate person. Well, welcome to the wonderful world of rock and roll, right?
Well, I started setting up further back from the edge of the stage after that. Good. You learn your lessons.
Good move. Well, you know, we were on these recordings that were done at a couple of venues that, you know, my father's place and the Bottom Line, as you recall. Yeah. They've been leaking out a little bit here and there. Have you noticed? Have you had a chance to listen to any of them?
Actually, I confess that I have a hand in the one from my father's place.
Oh.
I gave it to him. I had the CD, and I uploaded the songs, and he remastered them, and respectfully, with copyrights in place, and sent them back to me, and they sound amazing. I'm not sure if you have a copy. If you do not, I will make sure that you get one.
And when you say he, who would he be?
You know what? So bad with names.
Oh, doesn't matter.
Frank.
Doesn't matter.
He has a Beach Boys fan group.
Uh huh.
Something DJ 300.
Doesn't matter. Well, it's good to hear your voice, and you're still gigging. So you are what's known as a real professional musician. You're actually making a living out of doing it, and I salute you for that.
45 years.
God bless.
What a blessing.
Yeah, it really is, and I feel the same way that I'm able to play my songs, and well, play a lot of other people's songs too during the course of my show. John, I've played over 600 some odd songs in the course of the year doing these shows every week. So my chops are way up. Anyway, you got any other memories, parting thoughts before we close out?
You know, I left LA after the second album. I came back home, and I don't regret coming home. But I wish I could have been in both places, because I think I would have had more to do with Carl and more to do with you and the people, wonderful, wonderful people that I met through you and Carl. So I don't regret coming home, but I wish I was still there. Does that make any sense?
Yeah, it does. Oh, you'll be happy to know that I told the driving through the cornfield in the middle of the night story on one of my shows.
I can't believe you told that story.
Of course, I had to tell that story.
I was sound asleep. I had no idea what the hell was going on.
We were all sound asleep, even our driver.
It's the cornfield.
Anyway, on that happy note, we're alive and well to tell the tale. I'm going to say thank you so much for being a part of my show and for helping to make it so special for Carl and remembering him as fondly as you have. So keep up the good work, John, and I hope to see you sometime real soon down the line.
I'm so grateful for this. Thank you very much, Billy.
God bless you.
Well, my friend.
God bless you. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.
You too, man. Bye-bye.
Let's hear it for John Daly. Hard-working musician that he is. He's out there gigging tonight, so we thought we'd pre-record his interview. He was going to have to take a break, in the middle of a set in order to come in on time, so to speak, with my show, though my show is pretty loose with time, as you may have noticed. I'm going to play a couple of Carl songs, real upbeat stuff. This is Carl's single that was released off of I guess. Well, no, I don't think it was. I don't think it was on an album. Actually, it. It was something that we just. I think it was a one-off. I just actually don't remember exactly. But real upbeat. You know, Jerry Schilling, who managed Carl, personal manager for a while there, he encouraged Carl to leave his guitar behind, take the microphone, get up front, strut his stuff, and sing this song. And I must say, I'm not so sure Carl was completely comfortable with this, but he gave it a shot. And I gotta salute Carl for giving it a shot. And you know, that takes guts to just go out there when you're so used to being, you know, having the safety of a guitar around your neck. Do you know what I mean? In front of a band. So let's do this one. Sing along with me if you know it. If you're a real Beach Boy fan, you're gonna know this song. Especially if you're a Carl Wilson fan.
Do to you what you do to me.
Give yourselves a hand or two. I once asked Desi what was the sound of one hand clapping. I said, what's the sound of one hand clapping? I'm serious. And he thought about it and he went like this. Oh boy. You remember that, Desi? I'll never forget it. On a serious note, from the Beckley Lamb Wilson canon. Days when the sun is so clear and bright, a dream that's as real as the stars in the night. I wish for you always a heart that can heal when you love in vain, a friend who can hold you through all of the pain. I wish for you always, wish you hope through your shared tears, wish you peace all your living years. And when the moon is high, I wish you were here. Wisdom to trust in somebody else, the strength to believe most of all in yourself. I wish for you always, wish you hope through your share of tears, wish you peace all your living years. When the moon is high, I wish you were here, someone to stay with you right or wrong, someone to love every breath of your life. Wish for you always, I wish for you always, someone to stay with you wrong or right, someone to love every breath of your life. I wish for you always, I wish for you. It's been said that was written for Jonah and Justin Wilson, his sons. I feel sometimes it was written for me. Maybe sometimes you feel that was written just for you. Oh, boy. Well, on a lighter note, do you know what the most musical fruit is? Come on, you know this one. The most musical fruit. This requires a drum roll. Thank you very much. Chuck Berry. Look out. All right, I have a Q&A question from Mr. Paul Brandel, or is it Brandel? I bet I'm like 50-50 shot on that one. Paul's asked a question before. We don't mind every now and again if you repeat a query. He writes, I was at Carl's solo tour show at my father's place in Rosslyn, New York. The performance by Carl and the band was phenomenal. However, why was the set list so disappointingly short? Well, Paul, what can I tell you? When I think back to when I saw the Beatles at the Hollywood Bowl in 65, thank you very much, their set was only 20 minutes, 30 tops. So, as I recall, we did a pretty healthy set that night, hovering around 60 minutes. I mean, really, Carl didn't even have to do the solo shows. It's something that he did for the love of the music and to express himself, etc., etc. And Carl was running the show, and that's how many songs he wanted to do, and it's how long he wanted to do. That was up to him. Anyway, I hope that kind of sort of answered your question, Paul. I'm sorry you were disappointed in the brevity of the set list. I guess that's a compliment in and of itself. Well, folks, I'm going to close out. We've had a big night. Don't forget my big old birthday giveaway offer. Send in a little something, PayPal, Venmo. I will send you something back. Be sure to indicate what sort of category of gift you'd like from me in celebration of my birthday. We're gifting one another, so to speak, a Beach Boy-related, Chicago-related, Jan and Dean, Mike and Dean, or Dino, Desi, and Billy, Ricky, Desi, and Billy. I got so many things. I want to share them with everybody. So anyway, let's get on out of here. Make sure everything is correct. Amundo, we've had a big night tonight. Didn't I tell you we're going to have a big night? Oh, yeah. Big, big night of going solo. I hope you enjoyed all the guests and everything like that. I thought they were pretty cool. We're going out with a rocker. I'd be off my rocker if I didn't play a rocker as a closer. I remember Carl did this session with Vicky Hopkins on piano, the Englishman. And you'd see him in the studio from the booth. And he would, you could only see the top part. He wouldn't move, but his hands would be all over the place. And I had to learn this stuff when we did the shows, live shows. Here we go, here we go. Sticking around for my big going solo birthday bash show. It's been a pleasure and an honor to be able to come into your living rooms, and I certainly hope we can meet again next week, God willing, and the creek don't rise. And if you like what I'm doing, send in a little something. I'm going to send you something right back, and I'm going to, of course, give a portion of the proceeds to Music Cares, as I always do. And I'm going to write you a personal note of thanks along with my gift to you. And so, send a little something. Help me keep the lights on and the old air conditioner humming. Would you do that for me, please? I sure do want to thank you. All right, now, I'm not sure what next week's show is going to be. I'm leaning towards maybe another Wrecking Crew show with a special Wrecking Crew guest. That's where I'm leaning, so, but we'll see. I'll let you know. Now, last bit of advice. If you happen to get a message from me about canned meat, do not open it. It is spam, okay? Just so you know. That is crazy. Oh, the drummer went home. Okay, be that way. Be that way. All right, let's get on out of here, shall we?
Positivity every day. Positivity in every way. Positivity is what I need. Positivity, yes indeed, yeah. Positivity throughout the day. Positivity, that's what I say. Positivity is my friend. Positivity through thick and thin. Let's go. Positivity is good for my soul. Positivity for young and old. Positivity for everyone. Positivity, we just begun. That's right, folks. We just begun. Let's stay positive.
All for you. So, until we meet again, I sincerely hope that that all the wonderful blessings and wonders of this beautiful world come to you in this wonderful life that we have. Good night.